Welcome to Digital Communication Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain attenuation of signal and significance of decibel. And I'll explain those things by examples. So let us try to understand first what is attenuation of signal. Now see, attenuation of signal, that is a loss of energy, and that happens when signal propagates along the transmission line or along the transmission medium. So when signal propagates from one end to other end of transmission medium, there will be certain amount of energy which is getting lost, and that is what attenuation of signal. And there are so many reasons for attenuation of signal. When you talk about microstrip transmission line or coaxial transmission line, at that time attenuation happens because of conduction loss and dielectric loss. And there is one another reason, that is what propagation loss, that is what resulting attenuation. And attenuation will happen in wireless transmission medium even. Major loss of wireless transmission medium, that happens because of propagation loss. So there are these reasons like conduction loss, dielectric loss, propagation loss, that is resulting attenuation of signal in transmission medium. How to measure attenuation? So usually we measure attenuation in terms of dB, and there are some reasons behind we measure attenuation in terms of dB that we will discuss later in this session. To compensate attenuation, we use amplifier in our circuits. So let us try to understand how attenuation of signal that is happening and why do we measure that in terms of decibel. So first of all, when we talk about attenuation, if I say I'm sending signal from point 1 to point 2, and at point 1, if energy is E1, and at point 2, if energy is E2, then when it propagates through a medium, there will be loss of energy. So you will be finding always E2 that will be less than E1, and that is happening because of attenuation. Now, if you see how that happens with respect to signal, then you will be finding because of attenuation, shape of signal will not change. So if I say here, there are 4 points where we measure how signal will look like. Let us say this is point 1, this is point 2, this is point 3, and this is point 4. Now if signal is appearing like this at this point 1, then what will happen is when it propagates through medium, because of attenuation, this signal will get weak. So you'll be finding its shape will be same, frequency will be same, phase will be same, but magnitude of signal, that will decrease because of attenuation. Now, as I have told, to compensate attenuation, we use amplifier. So if I use amplifier here, I can amplify this signal. So at point 3, again, strong signal that we can have, and this amplification, that depends on what type of amplifier that we are using, and that is based on gain of amplifier. Sorry, this is what the symbol of amplifier. This line should not be there. That symbol is of diode. So this is the symbol of amplifier. So amplifier will amplify, boost the signal, and you will be increasing gain of signal. Again, when it propagates through a medium from point 3 to point 4, again its strength will decrease. So ultimately, attenuation of signal is what? Loss of energy, where you will not lose information. Remember this, attenuation will not destroy information. It will decay amplitude of signal. So attenuation decays amplitude of signal. You will not lose information. you will not lose information because of attenuation. Now, as I have told you, what is the basic significance which is there with dB, decibel? So usually when you see dB, it is been used to measure loss or gain of signal, and it is used to measure relative power or relative voltage loss or gain. So let us try to understand this by one example. So see here, if I say I have two points, this point 1 and this point 2, when signal propagates through a medium, if I say over here power is P1 and over here power is P2. So to have a measurement of relative power, we can say gain in terms of dB, that will be 10 log of output power, that is P2, divided by input power, that is P1. So that is how we measure gain. Now, if I want to measure relative voltage, if I say here voltage is V1, here voltage is V2. So as we know, power is proportional to square of voltage. So when you measure gain in terms of voltage, it will changes to 20 log of V2 by V1. So remember this, when you measure gain in terms of power, it will be 10 log of output power by input power, but it will be 20 log of output voltage by input voltage. So see, this is how we have a measurement of relative power or relative voltage in terms of dB. So this has been used to have a measurement of loss or gain. Now see how to identify whether loss is happening or whether gain is happening. So when you calculate this gain in terms of dB, and if that dB that is positive, it means there is a gain of signal. So in calculation, if this calculation is positive, you can say gain of signal is happening. If this calculation is negative, if this dB calculation is negative, one can say there is attenuation of signal, or one can say there is a loss of signal. See, by dB, we can measure gain or attenuation by just addition or subtraction along the propagation. So see how to do that. So for that, I'll give you one example so it will be more clear. Like see, if I say I have 4 points, right? This is point 1, this is point 2, this is point 3, and this is point 4. See, in between point 1 to point 2, if I say there is a loss of signal because of attenuation, and let us say that is 3 dB. In between 2 to 3, we are connecting amplifier, and that amplifier, again, see, this is what the symbol of amplifier. So this amplifier, that is of gain of, let us say, 10 dB. And from point 3 to point 4, let us say minus 4 dB loss is happening. So how much amount of dB that is happening in between point 1 to point 4? So that gain in terms of dB, that we can just calculate by adding all those gain and losses in terms of dB. So total gain, that will be equals to minus 3 plus 10 minus 4. So that will be plus 3 dB. So as this answer is plus, we can say there will be amplification of signal. And if this answer is negative, one can say there is attenuation of signal. So that is how significance of decibel is there, where measurement will be 10 log of power ratio, output power by input power, and in terms of voltage, it will be 20 log of voltage ratio, 20 log of output voltage by input voltage. And that will be having unit, that is what dB. And for a total calculation by dB addition, we can directly calculate how much gain is happening. So this is what one calculation which will be making your calculation easy. That's why people prefers dB. Let us have one more example so it will be more clear. See, suppose a signal travels through a transmission medium and its power is reduced to 1/4. In this case, attenuation can be calculated as, so here if I say signal is transferring from one point to other point, let us say here power is P1, here power is P2. So what is given here? Power is reduced to 1/4. What it means? P2, that is reduced to P1 by 4. So what will be attenuation here? So for that, we can calculate that in terms of dB. As I have told, it will be 10 log of output power P2 by input power P1. So that is 10 log of output power P2, that is P1 by 4, and divided by input power P1. So P1, P1 will get cancelled. You can say it is 10 log of 1 by 4. And if you do this calculation, it will be finding it is minus 6 dB. So as our calculation is negative, one can say there is attenuation, and that attenuation is of minus 6 dB. So negative dB calculation explains you attenuation, and positive dB calculation explains you amplification. So attenuation could be compensated easily by using amplifier in the circuit. And remember one thing always, attenuation will never destroy information. It will never change shape of signal. It will just decrease amplitude of signal. And attenuation could be easily compensated by amplifier. So this is what about this session. I hope that you have understood it. Thank you so much for watching this video. I have made this based on the request of one student. I hope now it is clear to him. He was having some questions regarding, sir, whether attenuation will destroy information or not. I was explaining him like it will not destroy information. The reason is attenuation is just decreasing amplitude. It is not destroying information. Information is always there in terms of frequency and phase of signal. Amplitude is just, we are sending it because of we need to send it to larger distance. So if you want to send signal for larger distance, higher amplitude is required. So this is what I want to explain him, but he was having some confusion regarding some basic understanding. I hope that now it is clear after viewing this video. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can give your valuable suggestions. Definitely based on it, in future he'll be finding so many other subjects are even happening. Next year I'm planning 7 different subjects regarding university, plus gate examination, plus other entrance examination. So that will be definitely going to benefit you. Thank you so much for watching this video.